Greetings, family, in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. My name is Kagiso Malepe, the announcer of the good news. Jesus saves, heals, and delivers. And of course, I'm influencing the influencers to reach their maximum potential. This is your day. This is your day. Our God is able to do exceedingly abundantly and above all we can ask or think of. Welcome to Life Changing Experience. And today, I want us to speak under the very interesting topic, give yourself holy or throw yourself. Give yourself holy. Another version says, throw yourself. I'm reading 1 Timothy chapter number 4, verse 12 to verse 16. Hallelujah. The Bible says, let no man despise thy youth. I want you to hear this. Let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity. And he says, till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. Neglect, listen to this part, verse 14. He says, neglect not the gift that is in thee, which was given thee by prophecy, with the laying on of the hands or of the presbytery. Verse number 15, it says, meditate upon these things, give thyself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear to all. Another version says, so that your progress will be visible to all. Verse 16 says, take heed unto thyself and unto doctrine, continue in them, for in doing this thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee. Remember, I said we are speaking under this topic, give yourself holy. Let's pray. Father, speak to us. We are listening to your word. Release the power of your living word in Jesus' name. Amen. So what we have read, we see Paul the apostle advising his mentee Timothy, or his son in the faith Timothy. He speaks to Timothy, and in this conversation there are a few points that we get. It's a mentor and mentee conversation, and Paul is saying to Timothy, Timothy, number one, I want you to make sure you don't allow anybody to look down on you because you are young. He says, don't allow anybody to look down on you because you are young. I'm encouraging you to give yourself holy. I'm encouraging you to throw yourself to God, to these things and these principles that I'm giving you. Because the moment you do this, you will see the results. You know, thy profiting will appear to all. You will see the results. Your progress will be visible. People will start to see your progress the moment you apply this principle. So Paul says to Timothy, I want to speak to you as a mentor and giving you principles, because the principles are very important. Principles are not like laws. Laws change, but principles never change. And I want to challenge you, Timothy. I want to teach you and give you this principle so that you can be a man who will be principled. Not just know principles, because there are many people who know principles, yet they are not principled. So, Timothy, I want you to be principled. I want you to be principled. That will help you to reach your maximum potential. That will help you to see the results in this area of your life, or in every area of your life, because principles never change. Whether you apply them in ministry, they will work for you. Whether you apply them in the mountain of business and investment, they will work for you. Whether you apply them in the mountain of politics, they will work for you. In the mountain of education or family, they will work for you. So he says, number one, don't let anyone look down on you because you are young. And I feel like expanding this line just a little bit and say, my brother, my sister, don't let anyone look down on you because you don't have money currently. This is just for a while. And I mean a while. A while is just a while. Oh my God. When I say a while, I mean it's just for a while. So don't let anybody look down on you because of where you were born. Don't let anyone look down on you because of your background. You are not defined by your background. You are not defined by your past, by your mistakes. No, you are defined by your destiny. I want to challenge somebody today. Refuse to be defined by your circumstance. Refuse to be defined by situations. Don't let anyone look down on you because of your current state. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. And number two, Paul says to Timothy, I want you, Timothy, my son, to set an example for believers in speech and in conduct. So in other words, he simply says to Timothy, I want you to be an example. Remember, an example is somebody who's different. You cannot be like other people and be an example. For you to be an example, it means you must be different. Timothy, my son, don't be afraid to be different. Don't try to fit in. Timothy, my son, I want to challenge you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Don't allow anybody to look down on you. Make sure that you are an example in speech and in conduct. In other words, you must make sure that the message and the messenger are one. Make sure that you live what you preach. Let your lifestyle show what you preach. My God, make sure you live what you preach. Be like Ezra. Ezra 7:10. The Bible says Ezra prepared his heart to seek the law of God, to do it, to teach it. So in other words, he did not teach it before he does it. So I want to challenge you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Timothy, my son, be an example in speech and in conduct. Remember, Paul said this words in one verse. He says, bad company corrupt good manners. So I want to challenge you today in the mighty name of Jesus, my son, be an example in speech and in conduct. And he says, also in love, be an example in love. Ratabato, rata semudimwase ratang. Love what God loves. Love who God loves. Be an example in love. Love what God loves. Ayamakate. And he says, in faith, you must also be an example in faith, because the just must live by faith. I love when the book of Hebrews says faith. Now faith is a substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And verse number 2 says, for by it the elders obtained a good report. So Paul says, I want you to obtain a good report, Timothy, my son. I also want you to make progress in your life. So just be an example in faith. Let believers see that when you live by faith, they will receive a good report in the mighty name of Jesus. And he says, also be an example in purity, holiness. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to challenge you today in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, without holiness, no man can see God. Without holiness, no man can see God. So Paul encourages Timothy and he says to Timothy, Timothy, my son, be an example even in purity. Number 3, he says, study, devote yourself to the public reading of scripture, to preaching and teaching. Paul says, I want you to throw yourself to these things that I'm giving you, because once you do that, you will see results, my son. I want you to give yourself wholly to these things. Give yourself wholly. Throw yourself to these things, because these are the principles that will help you to reach your maximum potential. These are the principles that will help you to make impact. So he says, make sure, Timothy, you study. One man said this word, he said, a reader today, a leader tomorrow. Make sure you study. E.W. Kenyon said, make your brain work. He said, it will sweat, it will develop, it will improve until you become the envy of every man around you. And he said, be committed to brain work. And now we see Timothy, Paul saying to Timothy, Timothy, my son, study, devote yourself to the public reading of scripture, to preaching and to teaching. Devote yourself, throw yourself to these things. And number 4, he says, don't neglect your gift. I want to stay on this point just for a few minutes. He says, don't neglect your gift. It is very important. Don't neglect your gift. I repeat that. Don't neglect your gift. Let me repeat it for the third time. Don't neglect your gift. Let me tell you why. Because the Bible says your gift is like a precious stone, and wherever wherever it tends, it will prosper. So don't neglect your gift. I repeat this. Don't neglect your gift. Why? Because your gift is the one, the Bible says, it will make room for you and it will make you to stand before the great man. Let me repeat this. It says your gift will make room for you and it will make you to stand before the great man. So make sure you don't neglect your gift. I repeat that. Don't neglect your gift. Why? Because your gift is the one that will put you on top. So Paul says to Timothy, make no mistake, my son. Don't neglect your gift. Work on it. Develop it. Someone maybe is asking this question. He says, how can I give attention to my gift? I don't want to neglect it. How do I do that? Let me tell you. Study. Make sure you study. Make sure you develop it. Make sure that you follow people who excel in that gifting. Learn things. Learn how they package themselves. Learn how they do things. I'm telling you, learn how they excel. You will see. You will also excel in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. But you see, as I'm speaking about this point, don't neglect your gift. Listen to me. Let me throw this point. It is very important. As much as the Bible says your gift will make room for you and it will make you to stand before the great man, right? You must understand that you are not going to sleep before the great man. You still have to come back home and sleep. What am I saying today? I'm saying to you, don't be moved by fame and neglect establishment. Use your gift to be established, because it is one thing to be famous, but it is one thing to be established. You don't want to be famous and at the end of the day, when you die, you left nothing for your children and your children's children. I want to challenge you today in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, I said I'm influencing the influencers. I want to challenge you. Don't be lost inside the crowd to such an extent that you will forget who you are. There is one principle I love about Jesus. The Bible says he often withdrew himself from the crowd to lonely places to do what? To pray. Why? Because he knew, when I am alone, I remember who I am. When I'm alone, my creative juices flow automatically. When I'm alone, I am able to unleash my potential. I'm saying to you, don't neglect your gift. But when it presents you before the great man, use your gift to be established. And number five, Paul says to Timothy, he said, be diligent. You see, your diligence will be rewarded. My God, I heard what I said. I said your diligence will be rewarded. And number six, Paul says to Timothy, he says, give yourself wholly, meaning throw yourself, which is the title of this message. He says, throw yourself to what? To the principles that I just gave you. Now, throw yourself wholly. He explains the reason why. He says, so that everyone may see your progress. Paul is simply saying, you don't want to talk this and people see this. Let people see your progress. Let the message and the messenger be one. It is my prayer and my cry in the mighty name of Jesus that as you throw yourself to these principles of the Word of God, as you throw yourself, that everyone will see your progress in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Then Paul speaks something very powerful to Timothy. He says, watch your life. Timothy, watch your life. In other words, you must learn to master yourself. You must learn to be disciplined. You must learn to have personal order, because you will never be a great leader, Timothy. You will never reach your maximum potential, Timothy, until you learn to master yourself. Watch your life and doctrine closely. Okay, watch it closely, and it says persevere in them. Why does Paul say to Timothy, persevere? Because he knows there will be moments where he feels like not being committed to his cause. There will be moments where he feels like he can neglect his gift. There will be moments where he feels like he can stop studying. There will be moments where he feels like throwing down the towel. But Paul mentions something powerful. He says, Timothy, my son, you just have to persevere in them. Because if you do, hallelujah, he says, if you do, you will save both yourself and your hearers. So in other words, perseverance is very important. Because now, if you don't do these things, if you quit, Timothy, my son, you will abort the greatness that you are carrying. You don't want to abort the greatness that you are carrying. You don't want to abort the vision that you are carrying. You don't want to abort the purpose that you are carrying. I want to challenge you wherever you are, in the mighty name of Jesus, that persevere. I know that you are carrying great things in you. I know God has given you a powerful vision. I know God has called you for great exploits. And in the name of Jesus, maybe some of you feel like throwing down the towel. In the name of Jesus today, I want to challenge you. Persevere, child of God. Don't throw down the towel. I say, don't throw down the towel. The God who started a great work in you will surely bring it to pass. Why? He is able to do exceedingly abundantly and above all you can ask or think of. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to challenge you. I want to challenge you with these words and say to you, watch your life and doctrine closely. What am I saying? I'm simply saying, be genuine and upgrade. Be genuine and upgrade. You see, when you watch your life and you watch your doctrine closely, it means you keep on checking your life and checking that what I'm doing or how I'm living, is it aligned with the word of God? That's what we mean. Watch your life and doctrine closely and persevere in them. So in other words, Paul simply says to Timothy, you just have to learn to be genuine and make sure that you continue to upgrade. He simply says to him, you just always need to learn the principle, measure and adjust. Measure and adjust. Always, Timothy, measure your life according to the word of God and adjust. Measure your life according to the word of God and adjust. He simply says, you're going to have that heart of humility that says, Lord, shape me, align me, and direct me. So that's what it means when you say, watch your life and doctrine closely. Then Paul says, persevere in them, because if you do, you will save both yourself and your hearers. You see, it is very important for you, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, to have that humility, to be genuine and upgrade, to measure and adjust, shape, align, direct. But here's a point. There's one thing I've discovered in my walk with God, is that before God shapes us, sometimes he has a tendency of breaking the current shape. And that process is so difficult. When God breaks the current shape, it's so difficult. Why? Because during that period and that season, God always challenges you to do three things. Three things as I conclude. God always challenges you to do three things. These three things you must know, when God demands them from you, it's the beginning where God will break you, and now he will start the shaping, aligning, and directing process. Number one, God will always challenge you to face yourself. That is why Paul speaks this way. He says to Timothy, watch your life and doctrine closely. Persevere in them. Why? Because he knows that God has a tendency to say, hey, munna, bo, na we, na munna. Make sure that you face yourself. Because when you watch yourself, it means you're going to have to check your weaknesses, right? You check the things that you hate about yourself. You check the things that you don't like about yourself. You check the things that you have to change. You check your strengths. You check your ability. Everything. That's what it means when he says face yourself. But this version says watch your life. So here I want to challenge you, face yourself. Actually, Let me tell you this. There are three things that you must do for yourself today. I'm concluding with these 3 points. Three things. Because I am saying to you, give yourself holy. Throw yourself to the word of God, to the principles and the keys that I just gave you today. Throw yourself. So there are three things that you just need to do. One, face yourself. Face yourself. And you see, when you face yourself, be true to yourself. There was a season and time when I really had to face myself, and I was very true to myself. I said, Kagiso, this is how you are. You don't greet people. You are arrogant. You need to change this. You don't like this. Change. That's what we mean. Face yourself. If you don't greet people, if you don't treat people right, you're gonna close doors that God has opened for you. So it's very important for you to face yourself. Number two, make sure that you face your enemies. When I talk about facing your enemies, I'm not talking about people. I'm talking about your enemies like fear. There are people who live in fear to such an extent that they are scared to be true to themselves. They are scared to become brave. I mean, they are not brave enough to be true to themselves. They always try to please people. And let me say this point today. Never ever live your life to prove a point to people. You will hurt yourself with people who care less about you. Let me repeat what I said. Never ever live your life to prove a point to people. You will hurt yourself with people who care less about you. So now, face your enemies. Enemies of condemnation. Probably you are condemning yourself because of your past. You must constantly face those things and keep on telling yourself and reminding yourself, I am not my mistakes. I am who God says I am. I am anointed and I am appointed for action. You must constantly remind yourself, I refuse to condemn myself. What I have done was just a learning curve. Those lessons are the lessons that any university was not gonna give me. Listen to me. It is very important. It is very important that you face your enemies and confront them directly. And number three, face your worst fear. Face your worst fear. What am I talking about? You see, for me, my worst fear for many years, it was rejection. And God challenged me to face my worst fear, rejection. I had to do it for myself. Let me tell you, I had to do it for myself. And thinking that I'm doing it for myself, I did not know that I'm also doing it for the coming generation. Because what you fail to address in your generation will definitely affect the coming generation. So you need that boldness in your family. You need that boldness in your career, in your business to face your worst fear. You see, rejection. One of the dangers I saw about my worst fear, which was rejection, it was constantly making me to rehearse, not to make mistakes, to such an extent that I was not starting anything in life. So I want to challenge you today, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. If you are that one who fear rejection, today your story can change. Apply the same principles I spoke about. One, don't let anyone look down on you. Don't look down on yourself. Don't look down on yourself. Maybe I need to put it this way. Don't look down on yourself. Make sure you invest in your greatest resource, and you are that greatest resource. Develop yourself. Embrace the ethic and discipline of hard work. Let me tell you, throw yourself to the word of God, to the principles that I gave you. You will see your progress will be seen by everyone around you in the name of Jesus. That is why Paul says, make it your goal to live a quiet life. And he says, minding your own business and working with your hands. I want to challenge you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Throw yourself. It is my prayer today that God will give you the grace to throw yourself. God will give you the grace to be that man who will be principled. Be principles. Be principled. Not only just knowing principles, but be principles. Be principled. I love you so much in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. My prayer for you today is that God will give you wisdom. God will give you grace and an excellent spirit in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. If you are sick, receive your healing wherever you are in Jesus' name. My name is Kagiso Malepe. If you'd like to follow me, you say KM_Kagiso Malepe on Instagram. On Twitter, you say at KM_Kagiso Malepe. On YouTube, you say Kagiso Malepe TV. And make sure you click subscribe button, click the notification button, so that each time we upload a video, you will get your notification. I love you so much. May the Lord bless you. Till next time. Amen.